गुड आफ्टरनून क्लास, टुडे वी विल बी सीइंग अ न्यू यूनिट इन योर सब्जेक्ट मास ट्रांसफर ऑपरेशन 2. द यूनिट वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग टुडे इज ड्राइंग. सो व्हाट इज ड्राइंग? इट रिफर्स टू एन ऑपरेशन इन विच मॉइस्चर ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस इज रिमूव्ड. व्हेन वी हियर द वर्ड ड्राइंग, ऑफकोर्स वी व्हाट वी इमेजिन इज रिमूवल ऑफ मॉइस्चर फ्रॉम अ सब्सटेंस. It usually refers to removal of relatively small amounts of moisture or water from a solid or a near solid material. Transfer of liquid takes place from a wet solid into an unsaturated gas phase. During drying, moisture is removed from a solid mainly by means of thermal energy. So here thermal energy or heat we can say is used to perform drying. Now during drying operation, both mass and heat transfer occur simultaneously. What happens here is heat is transferred from bulk of gas phase, which we call drying medium, to the solid phase. So what is happening? Heat is going from gas phase to solid phase, and in exchange mass is transferred from solid phase to gas phase in the form of liquid or vapor through various resistances. The liquid that is transferred is the solute, and transfer takes place as gas phase is always unsaturated. What they are trying to say here is the liquid that is transferring from gas phase is the solute. We call it solute, and transfer takes place in the gas phase as gas phase is always unsaturated. So next we have drying principle, basic principle on which drying works. First is migration of moisture from the interior of a material to its surface. As discussed earlier, the solid phase, from solid phase moisture comes to the upward to the exterior part of the solid surface, and evaporation of that moisture from surface to surrounding air. So first the moisture from the internal parts of solid surface comes to the surface, and the moisture that has come up on the surface is then evaporated into the gas phase, here surrounding air. Now when we hear drying, one other common word that comes to our mind is evaporation, and how it is different from evaporation. So we will be discussing differences between drying and evaporation. So the major difference, as discussed in point 1 here, is their definition. The main operation is usually carried out on solid materials in drying, whereas in evaporation the main operation occurs in liquid, as we use evaporation term only for majorly for liquid materials. Next, drying in most of the cases means the removal of relatively small amounts of water from solids. In drying, what we are doing is we are drying the solid and removing moisture from solid materials, a wet solid material, and we are drying it. Whereas in evaporation, removal of large amount of water takes place. A small amount of evaporation from the surface of solid material does not count as evaporation. It is termed as drying. In most cases, drying involves removal of water at temperature below its boiling point. For evaporation, it is important that the liquid reaches its boiling point, whereas in drying, it is not important for the liquid material to reach its boiling point. Drying can take place even at a temperature below its boiling point. Whereas, as I said, in evaporation, removal of water is done at boiling point. Next, in drying, water is usually removed by circulating air over the material in order to carry away the water vapor. What happens here? Water is usually removed by circulating air over the material. It is not a constant, whereas in evaporation what we do is vapor is mixed with other gases and water is removed. But here the air is circulated over the material, and water vapor to carry away the water vapor. Water vapor is carried away, and the solid material is dried. And in evaporation, water is removed from the material as pure water vapor mixed with other gases. Drying finds its application in various range of industries. Here are some names where drying can be commonly used. Textile industries, paper and allied product industries, chemical industries, of course, food industries, herbal industries, pharmaceutical industries. So these are the names where drying application is majorly used. We'll be discussing types of drying equipments further in this unit. There we will see these applications. Now, further, as the removal of moisture by thermal means is more costly than mechanical means, the moisture content of solid must be reduced to minimum possible level before drying it. So, drying equipments are costly and so is drying operation. So, what should be our goal before drying, before feeding the solid material into drying, we should remove maximum possible moisture by mechanical means. And only then the solid should be fed into the drying equipments. In most of drying operation, heat is provided by hot air or any other gas drying medium. Drying is frequently the last operation in manufacturing process and is usually carried after evaporation, filtration or crystallization. Drying is the mostly last operation taking place. So it is majorly it is the last step in any industry. After all other operations are carried out, drying is carried out at the end, and after drying we get the final product. Drying operations are mostly encountered in food, chemical, agriculture, pharmaceutical and textile industry, as we saw earlier in the applications. Now, what is the main purpose of drying? Why we need to dry the product and why cannot we use it in the form as it is? First, for reducing the transport cost. As we all know, transportation of solid is much easier as compared to transport of liquid products. So, and also easy to handle while transporting with lesser care. So, for that, drying is important, and it is a good purpose that if we convert a product or dry a product out before its transportation. Then next is purifying a crystalline product so that solvent adhering to crystals is removed. Next, for making a material more suitable for handling and storage. Also before transportation, handling and storage is to be done. So same for the reason is same as first point. Handling and storage of dry solids is easy to meet the market specifications of solid products set by customers. As consumers, we also want products, or we also request for products which we can easily transport, handle and store, and so it is dry. For providing definite properties to a material, if the products are not dried and kept in liquid form, so its properties can change according to change in temperature conditions. So it is recommended to dry the products to fix its properties. In some cases, for preventing corrosion arising due to presence of moisture, also this is another reason to prevent corrosion, drying is done. Dry chlorine gas is not corrosive, but traces of moisture makes it very corrosive. Hence, chlorine gas is dried. Sometimes it is an essential part of the process. Sometimes drying is essential part of the process. For example, as mentioned here, paper. We cannot write on wet paper or paper with moisture content in it. So it is important to dry it before using it as a final product. So this was all about introduction of drying, its working principles, applications and common purposes. Moving forward, now we'll discuss some terminologies or general definitions we'll be using in this topic. First is moisture content by wet basis. Mathematically, what is it? It is expressed as ratio of weight of the moisture, here x, to the weight of the wet feed material. Okay, so what they are trying to say is here x is the kg moisture with or moisture content in every 1 kg of dry solids. Then what will be our moisture content? Moisture content will be x upon 1 plus x. Percentage moisture on wet basis is the moisture associated with feed material expressed as a percentage of weight of feed material. Simply multiplying the moisture content on wet basis by 100. Here, what X is? X is the weight of kg moisture, weight in kg of the moisture per 1 kg of dry solids. And to find percentage weight moisture content on wet basis, simply we will multiply moisture content on wet basis with 100. Then next is moisture content by dry basis. It is expressed as the ratio of weight of moisture to the weight of dry solids present in a wet feed material. Total dry solids present in a wet feed material and ratio, its ratio with moisture content weight and weight of dry solids. Here X is the kg moisture and 1 is kg of dry solids, because we are finding it per 1 kg of dry solid. And it again, to find percentage of moisture content on dry basis, we will multiply it by 100. Another terminology is equilibrium moisture content. It is denoted by X star. It is defined as the moisture content of a solid material that is in equilibrium, thermodynamic equilibrium with its vapor. So when a solid material, the solid material from which we have to remove moisture, if it is in equilibrium, in thermodynamic equilibrium with its vapor in the gas phase under specific humidity and temperature of hot gas or air, whatever thermal means we are using, if that solid material is in thermodynamic equilibrium with its vapor form, that moisture content is known as equilibrium moisture content. The main or the important function of finding equilibrium moisture content is that it represents to what extent or to what limit we can dry a material under constant drying conditions. Equilibrium moisture content will give us the moisture content that after this limit or this extent, even if we keep on drying it constantly, there is not the result is not going to change. Next is bound moisture content. It is defined as the moisture in a solid material which exerts a vapor pressure less than that of the pure liquid at the same temperature. So what we understand from this definition is that the solid material which we have to dry, a part of moisture from that solid material exerts a vapor pressure less than that of a pure liquid. So when the vapor pressure of the moisture from the solid material which we are talking about, if it is less than the vapor pressure which a pure liquid at the same temperature will exert, then that moisture is known as bound moisture content. Further, next definition is unbound moisture content. So what is it? It is defined as moisture held by solid materials in excess of the equilibrium moisture content corresponding to saturation humidity. So earlier we saw what equilibrium moisture content is. So any solid material can have moisture content as equilibrium solid equilibrium moisture content, but it also carries or holds some extra moisture, and that extra moisture, excess moisture which can be contained or held by solid, is known as unbound moisture content. Mainly it is held in the voids of the solid that we are drying. In other words, there is another definition for unbound moisture content, which states that moisture in a solid material which exerts an equilibrium vapor pressure equal to that of the pure liquid at the given temperature, that moisture content is unbound moisture content. Further, there are other terms like free moisture content or critical moisture content, rate of drying, and other drying equipments which we'll be continuing in this unit ahead.